Last line. You guys are so good for sticking with this till here. We're in E minor. Okay. We're on root position and it got a seventh. So it's a one minor seven like that. Okay. And then this becomes the third of the chord. So that means that it's a triad and that the C is the root, which is a six. Don't forget that six chords are major in minor keys, okay? Here we have a C with its root, but it's got a seventh on there, so it's a six, and because we don't want it to look like a dominant seven, we'll put a large M right there, because six chords, supertonic set are, sorry, submediant chords are major seventh chords in minor keys. And then it changes, this is actually a little sequential pattern, so now this is no longer the root, right? This is the third of a triad, this is an A chord. A's are fours, just like that, minor, right? And then it goes to root position right here. So it's still another four right there. Here's my five chord. See, this is so and do, so and do. Being able to recognize your solfege or what function the notes are in a key is not just for singing, but for analysis. If you have a quick eye to see that that's do and you know that this is so, then you know that this is a five chord. You'll see this a lot with the seventh. And the middle note is modified, so it's B, D sharp because of that, the third above the note, and then F sharp because of the key signature, and A, this is my 5-7 chord. And here's a surprise, here's my one chord again, but it's got a sharp here. So remember, that's there like that. If I go E, and then the third above the note is going to be a G sharp because it's modified, and B, this is a major one chord. And this happens a lot in Baroque music and sad ballads in the 80s, where you, and 70s, where you take a minor piece and at the very end you change it to major one chord. We're actually borrowing this chord from the parallel major, E major, and they used to do it at the end of sad pieces in the Baroque, and even as early as the Renaissance and things like that, to sort of blunt the idea that it's still a happy ending, or at least bittersweet, it's not completely tragic. So, by reading the figure bass, we get the nuances of what the composer or the song is all about. Good job. I hope by now you're starting to get very quick at these. And if there's some things that you're not quick at, you just want to not ignore that. You might be like good at 80% of this, but maybe you still have problems with calculating 6-4s or 4-2s or something like that. You can take some time and do that. Maybe you're not quite as happy with slash through the note. There's no pluses in this, so we didn't do an augmented symbol. But, you know, yeah. So go back to your textbook, or you can ask me specific questions as well. But even if you don't have it perfectly down, consider how much you do have down now, and then, you know, be thoughtful and go and tackle those last little areas. All right, good job.